you know, winner, I'm sorry, or icon, I'm sorry, but that's just how the world works. Welcome to YouTube's favorite K-pop show, DKU. My name is Danny Kim.
David Kim.
And today we have lots and lots of hot-ass tea for you.
First off,
Korea does not want female police officers anymore. And second, the Changjaehyun case has come to a conclusion finally.
And third, icon winner are getting boycotted.
Oh no, what now? Uh-oh. First news, Koreans don't want female police officers anymore.
Oh no, why?
This has been like the biggest hot news in Korea the past week or so. Mm-hmm. On May 13th, someone posted online a footage of two police officers handling two drunk men. One of the drunk people slapped a police officer in the face.
Oh, no.
And he was a male police officer. And immediately after that, the police officer made an arrest, mm-hmm. which the drunk person resisted, and his other drunk friend tried helping him out by taking the police officer off of the downed drunk man. Now, a female police officer was partnering up with the male police officer, and she tried to push the other person away. However, as you can see in this video, she seemed to have trouble dealing with the drunk man, and basically when this went up online, everybody in Korea was like, yo, female police officers are useless. Well, after that, the police came out with a rebuttal.
Mm-hmm.
They revealed a full 2-minute video that showed what happened after the female police officer was struggling with a drunk man. The full footage showed that the female police officer eventually suppressed the drunk man, mm-hmm. And made an arrest, also along with her notifying the drunk man of his Miranda rights. However, the problem was, in between the female police officer struggling with the drunk man and making the arrest, she says something that made everybody even more pissed.
Mm-hmm.
And that was, she called for help. And not just any help, she's called for help to a passerby that was a male. She said it in a tone that was like kind of like commanding. Basically, that ended up backfiring. So the police were trying to make the situation better, but it ended up backfiring, and people are now even more pissed, and they're saying like, oh look, a female police officer, she can't even handle one drunk person by herself.
The drunk person was kind of old, right?
According to press reports, they say he was in his 40s.
40s.
People were like, oh, this woman can't even handle, you know, one drunk guy. How is she a police officer if she needs the help of a civilian? Police later clarified, saying that the passerby who helped with the arrest was actually not just a civilian, but a police officer himself. Not a lot of people bought that, actually.
We don't have footage about it.
We don't have footage of who that person was, but the police did say it was a passer. It was a police officer, so I guess we could believe that. Adding more fuel to the situation was KBS, which is Korea's national broadcasting station. They basically put out a report on this incident saying, oh, actually this female officer did a really great job. Mm. They showed what they called the full footage of the incident, but they had edited out the part where the female officer had been calling out a man for help.
Mm-hmm.
And basically they inserted audio clip that appeared at the end of her, you know, just announcing the Miranda rights.
여경은 침착하게 미란다 원칙까지 고지합니다.
지금 가급적으로 현행 모습 포함이다. 선임할 수 있고 변명의 기회 있고 적부심을.
It made it seem like she was making a very smooth arrest when she had actually called for somebody else's help.
I have no idea why KBS would edit it that way.
Their excuse was, we have limited broadcasting time. This was what made people really, really, really pissed.
I know.
Right now, it's like every single day I see it on the news. I see everybody bashing the
female
police.
It's always on trending. Yeah.
Yeah, it's crazy right now. This is the biggest news in Korea. And what I wanted to debate about was, is this outrage justifiable, or is this just another day in misogynistic Korea?
Two, three.
Okay.
It's justifiable. The police should have the abilities to safely protect citizens, right? Mm. And at this case, just looking at this case only, the police could not do their job. I don't think people are mad because like she's a female or whatever. If it was even a male, they would be mad too, because it was a 40-year-old drunk person, and a police officer couldn't get the drunk person handcuffed. Just looking at the person's job, the police officer couldn't do his or her job. And then comes in like the female factor, I think. Coincidentally, she was a female. There has been a lot of talks before in the past about female officers. There have been a lot of memes and pictures of them like taking tests, like easier tests than males.
They do push-ups with their knees on the ground.
I would say that is okay and that is rational because like we both have physical differences and physical strength is both different. But at the same time, at the end, everyone is a police officer. And if there is a very dangerous situation, female or not, should be ready for every kind of situation. And in this case, she was not. Like, just what I see. That's why everyone got furious. And just to continue a little bit more, I think there should be like stronger bars set for the police exam. I feel myself like police are treated as shit in Korea. Like people, ordinary citizens just see them as like, I don't know, volunteer workers.
Look at how confidently he slapped
the
dude.
They have no authority. And I think that's because they give a weak image and they have a weak entry. I don't think we should go into misogyny or anything. It's just about the police doing their job. And she was coincidentally a female and people got triggered about it.
Honestly, myself, my initial reaction was like, what the fuck is she doing?
Right.
Like, she's calling out a passerby
right.
for help when your job is to protect the passerbys, right? So that was my initial reaction. But I have a friend who's a police officer right now. I have friends everywhere.
Yeah.
These are not made up, by the way. I actually called him about this. And I asked him, like, yo, like, what do you think about the situation? And obviously, he's biased because he's the police. But he says, like, even as a male police officer who's well-trained and fit, it's very difficult for him to handcuff somebody on his own. He says it's understandable that she could not do it by herself. It's not the problem of her being a female. So in that sense, I don't think she deserves this much criticism.
Right.
But at the same time, you know, just to like somebody who's not educated on that, like it just looks bad, right?
Yeah.
It just looks like... Another thing that I noticed was when male police officers do something wrong, nobody talks about them being a man.
Right.
But when a female police officer does something wrong, it's almost like people are looking for things to criticize female officers on.
Right.
Because when a female officer does anything like this, God forbid, then it's always like, oh, look, see, I told you, you know, we don't need female police officers in this country.
Yeah, I think that's the reason why this issue is so complex and it's so like such a hot potato in Korea. Misogynist factors are like... Like mixed in.
I mean, these are legit concerns, but on top of that, it's like, I think it's a very knee-jerk reaction to say, let's get rid of all the police female police officers. They're useless. And I think what's worth talking about is like the state of mind that a lot of Korean males are in right now. It's a very turbulent time to be living as a Korean guy. The environment that we grew up in, like say 10 years ago, like the shit that we could be able to say and the shit that we could say now, it's completely different. You know what I mean? Like the political climate for especially a Korean male has become completely different. For a lot of people, it's very threatening. They feel threatened.
As a male?
Yeah.
Are you sure you want to say this?
Yeah, they feel threatened. I'm not saying I feel threatened. Well, I do feel threatened. They're feeling threatened because what they thought was obvious or, you know, like that what they thought was the norm are now being changed very radically, in a very radical pace. And they're feeling very threatened. They're feeling like they're losing ground. And that's why they're looking for things to just blame women on. They're looking for every single little mistake that a woman makes.
Okay, so I agree on that, like being threatened technically.
Yeah.
But I don't agree that being threatened means the males are the victims.
I'm not saying they're the victims. Yeah. They're feeling like they're
the
victims.
They have like this much and they're just giving out this much.
Yeah, yeah.
And it's natural for a person to be threatened by being taken of what his is. But like at the same time, it's just giving this much to the females. And like the scale is just like, you know.
I know, but people. I'm just saying like for them, it's like psychologically, emotionally, they're taking it in as like a threat.
Right. But I don't understand why you are threatened.
Well, because I'm a male. I'm a Korean male. I feel threatened too. But I'm also on logical level where like I can think logically, okay, this is how the world goes now. Like it's a very emotional.
But you don't approve.
What?
You don't approve?
I approve of what?
The direction. You don't.
No,
think
I agree with it. I agree with the direction. Okay. I'm just saying I feel threatened. But and it's a very knee-jerk reaction.
I don't know.
It's like, a very human thing to feel threatened.
Honestly,
yo.
But I don't feel threatened at all. Like okay. I feel
well,
like.
Well, my fragile masculinity feels threatened. I'm not saying I'm gonna go off hating female, you know, cops. But it's just saying like this is why these reactions are happening. And I see it all the time in male-dominant online communities where they try to nitpick every single little thing that a female does wrong, and it's like they just overgeneralize it, saying, oh, see, all girls are like this, all women are like this.
Agreed.
And this is a very common trend, and I think this is just one of the things that are just the symptoms of radically changing society.
Agreed.
So, all in all, I do think like the misogynistic culture or the mindset of a lot of people have to do with this. But at the same time, I do agree with David. We need higher bars for police officers. I'm going to say it, especially the female police officers, because right now, if you look at the female police officers, the physical test that they take compared to other countries, like for female officers, it's very, very low.
So I do think there needs to be a higher standard. But at the same time, I do feel that physical ability is not the only thing that's important to, you know, be a police officer. There's a lot of things that a female could do that's not about physical ability. You know, Park Chang-won, he's like a expert in the police. He said like 70% of police work is communication. It's communicating with the civilians and the citizens. People always think like, oh, police are there to catch robbers and, you know, catch like murderers. But 70% of their work is just, you know, good communication. So I think there's a very big role that a woman can play in that. And I think it's really stupid that people only think, oh, she's not fit, so you don't get to be police. There's a lot of different things that she could contribute potentially to the police.
So there you go. That's my fragile masculinity feeling threatened.
Though, like,
what?
It kind of felt like you're restricting the roles of.
Okay, well, I'm not saying that, but I'm just saying, like, since women. Next news. So, Chang Jae-yeon case. If you guys don't know, go watch our video that explained the Chang Jae-yeon case. It's basically a case that happened in 2009 where this actress named Chang Jae-yeon, she committed suicide after being sexually assaulted by about 30 plus
allegedly.
Media executives, allegedly politicians and important people. Mm-hmm. This case was being looked into for potential reinvestigation by the investigative team of past affairs. For the past 13 months, this case was being looked into for potential reinvestigation. However, on May 20th, the investigative team of past affairs concluded that the sexual assault charges and allegations regarding the Chang Jae-yeon case cannot be reinvestigated anymore. They said that there was a lack of evidence to reopen the investigations for the sexual assault charges.
Which makes sense because it was like 10 years ago.
It was 10 years ago, yeah. Right? However, they did admit to a lack of effort initially when they were investigating it in 2009.
That's a start.
They did admit to that. And they also admitted to external influences that and pressure that caused them the lack of effort from Joseon Ilbo, which is one of Korea's biggest news outlets. They admitted that something was cooking. It's just that there's no hard evidence enough to put anybody in. Furthermore, the investigative team concluded that the Chang Jae-yeon case could not be proven to exist. The Chang Jae-yeon list was basically a list of names, which allegedly had the names of media executives and politicians and whatnot who had sexually assaulted Chang Jae-yeon. And Yoon Ji-yeol, who was the sole witness and the testifier for the Chang Jae-yeon list, claimed that this list, you know, included such and such names, which she did not clarify. It was names of big people. But the investigative team concluded that they could not prove that this list actually existed. So this list was just dropped. They said that Yoon Ji-yeol's testimonies, which she did for like 10 plus times, could not be accounted as evidence because lack of proof, and they were secondhand accounts mostly. One good thing maybe was that they did reopen investigations for this one journalist who was involved in the Changjian case. I guess they found enough evidence for that. So he's on trial right now. But everything else is just done. The investigative team did order their prosecutors to keep the records of the investigations until 2024 June 29th, which is the expiry date for this case, but did not order any reinvestigations. So it's like if new evidence comes in on its own, then we might reopen the case, but it's like it's very unlikely, and I think this is just done.
A lot of people had hopes, but at the same time had doubts, and I think the results were kind of like already foreseen, and it's just sad.
It's sad that they had to wait this long. Literally, there's just nothing we can do. It's done. If you bring new evidence, we'll entertain you. That's what they're saying.
So I think it's technically over. But I think this has a meaning. It has a significance because in the future, powerful people like media executives or politicians, they'll fear
that this shit can happen.
Yeah, they'll fear this shit can happen and they
then
will
be let go. They investigated 80 people. Nobody was caught.
No. Because if this is a case like that happened recently, then like shit would go down. Like they would all go to jail and stuff. But because this is like such an old case, like 10 years ago, it's really hard to find evidence. I'm sure the people who were accused of being like the sexual offenders were shuddering and were afraid in their homes, and they would have the fear, and that fear would spread among the powerful people. So I guess like this would
That's the only good thing.
Yeah.
Keeps them in check, but at the end we let you go anyway.
No.
Next news.
So it's festival season. Ooh. Let's convert to a brighter topic. Oh, I was so down. My school had their festival recently called Akaraka, and a lot of artists came, like Twice, Red Velvet, Benzino, Zico. And actually, the university's festival season is one of the most profitable for idols and artists because they go touring like domestically to all these universities. Yeah. We have tons of universities.
We have like 200. Way too many universities.
Yeah, and they just collect all the money. It's a very good season for idols, but not for two particular idol groups.
Oh no.
Which are Icon and Winner.
Because they're from the same company that is so problematic?
Yes. So yeah, they're basically from YG Entertainment, which has been on the news for
the past year. Half a year.
The news hasn't been stopping about YG.
Feels like 10 years. I don't know.
You know why? It's because of the Burning Sun incident and then Seungri and then YG
himself.
There are a lot of allegations that YG did dirty work and they had ties with tax evasions, and they were the company Seungri was in. A lot of negative energy is collected in YG.
So anyways, Icon and Winner have been attempted to be boycotted, actually. Attempted to be boycotted. So from the student council of Hanyang University, Erica Campus, they announced that within their lineup for the festival, Winner was included. In their internet community in Facebook, an anonymous person wrote a full-length essay about why Winner should not come to the festival. They should boycott YG groups. The reasoning behind that was our school funds should not go to a criminal company like YG. Person also said that I am not blaming or accusing Winner for doing anything, but at the same time they are included in YG, so the person just wanted like justice or YG to serve their social responsibilities and stuff like that. A lot of people actually agreed to this, and this post got viral, but I just have to clarify this fact. The anonymous person was revealed not to be an actual student of that campus or university. It was a person outside of the, besides Hanyang University, there was another university called Myeongji University. Myeongji University invited Icon to their festival. One of the students in their school put up a daejabo. The whole poster was saying consuming YGs or calling YGs artists is giving money and supporting this criminal company, so we should not do that and boycott them. The stance of this poster was pretty strong and it got viral as well on Facebook. But nevertheless, they did not cancel the lineup. Icon is actually going to Myeongju University and everything's fine. I've actually brought some comments. I brought the top five comments and the first one is, can you read it for me?
우리 은행은 정신 나간다.
우리 은행 is a bank in Korea.
It's and their advertisers, their advertisement models are Icon or Winner?
Blackpink.
Oh, Blackpink.
So it's totally irrelevant to this article and to this case. But now the sparks are firing to Blackpink as well because they're YG.
Okay.
So like people are now going like onto Blackpink as well. So Icon, Winner, Blackpink, and who knows, like maybe Treasure Box. Uh-huh. Everyone is canceled in YG, boycotted. Yeah, yeah. And it has like 510 likes. It's like most upvoted.
Wow.
The next comment says, university students having that social awareness is a good thing.
So this is gonna make an interesting debate. Mm. Is boycotting other YG artists based on the Burning Sun scandal or other allegations on YG fair? 3, 2, 1.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I wanted to say this last week, the managers parking in, you know, handicapped spaces and shit like that. And I'm not even really talking about YG here. Mm. Like, I don't think like this only applies to YG. It's just business.
This is business. Right.
Okay, so here's the thing. I'm not saying Steve Jobs did this, but say Steve Jobs does some pretty weird shit or pretty fucked up shit. Mm. People are gonna say, let's not buy Apple products. They're not gonna say,
oh, you know, the people that make the Apple products, the engineers, you know, the Foxconn people and shit like that. It's not their fault. You know, it's not their fault. So let's keep buying Apple products, but just fuck, you know, Steve Jobs over.
People aren't gonna say that. They're gonna just say, fuck Apple, you know, fuck their brands. And I think the same applies to K-pop or any other business. I'm not necessarily saying like YG, all their allegations are true, but if you're buying something from, you know, a company that does not have a good track record, essentially you're still supporting their business. Icon, I'm sorry, but that's just how the world works. It doesn't work in a way where like, oh, I get to receive all the support and help and this press that this company helped me get, but I don't want to have any responsibility in, you know, being associated with it when it turns bad. It goes both ways.
What you're saying about the parking issue is that even if the managers did the fault, and the artist kind of gets some shit.
Essentially, you're one team. As an idol, you're the face of the team. You're the face of the team. It sucks, I know. Like, you know, it's not your fault that the manager parked there. It's probably not your fault, and you probably don't have a say. But at the same time, if you're the face of the team, you take it for the team. That's why you're the idol, and that's why you're not the manager. I'm sorry for Winner and Icon that they have to experience this, but at the same time, I'm very glad that these college students are socially aware enough to be making, you know, posters and comments like these. I completely agree with their decision.
I know that idols are products as well.
Yeah.
But at the same time, they're human beings. And Apple products are just iPhones and MacBooks.
But there's people behind those products.
I know. But like, it's easy to not buy products. If you actually see like K-pop idols, they're like human beings that actually devote their life and they have effort behind it and, you know, all that kind of stuff. So like the human factor kind of comes in. And when you look at these people, they've practiced so hard.
Winner just came back and they're like, they must be hyped to go like perform in festivals and stuff. And suddenly because of their senpai who did something wrong and their parent company, their performances get canceled. I mean, as a human being, you have to feel pity for them. And I think
I do feel pity.
Yeah, you do feel pity. And
canceling these like individual respective people's hard work and like sweat is just not right. It's like I'm sure there are other ways to boycott that company. They were aware about like boycotting YG. They should have done it in the first place by doing some other movement before like the festival seasons. And now that they're coming out right now, like they're canceling them. I don't know.
I don't agree with you because if you're paying, say, like, you know, Icon, I don't know, $20,000 to perform 5 songs, big chunk of that is gonna go to YG. Mm. You're essentially supporting that company. So you're not only supporting Icon, and I don't think there's any way to like personally support Icon. So I don't think there's any way like where you could say like I only want to support these boys, but I don't support YG.
Yeah, I understand.
That's just the nature. Like that's just the way the world works. I mean, People don't give a shit about.
I understand. I'm just like sad.
I'm sad too. I feel bad. I would be fucked. It's like you being canceled because you're with me.
That happens all the time.
Exactly. So you can relate. But at the same time, you're part of DKDK TV too. So in an essence, we're one team. And so if I make a mistake, you're going to take some responsibility for it too.
Oh, so it's my initial mistake partnering up with you.
Exactly. Exactly.
So I mean,
no one forced you, man. No one forced you. We did it on our free will. You could have run away anytime you wanted. But
this conclusion.
Okay. So essentially, like, if you're
okay,
you're under a company, you're gaining benefit from that company, they've trained you, well, then you're associated with that company. And when they go down, you go down too. That's just the way it works. I'm sorry, Icon. I'm sorry, Winner. I love your music. And I'm sure you're great people. But at the same time, you can't just take something good and then leave out the bad.
I don't know.
Spit out the bad. And people, speak with your dollars.
I don't know.
Speak with your dollars, man.
Despite whatever Danny's saying, it's all logical and stuff. I kind of agree to the logic. Okay. But at the same
time, I have human emotions
and I want to support them because their comeback is so good.
Is a product.
Yeah, so good.
K-pop is a product.
They deserve to perform right now.
Hey.
They should perform. Universities,
iPhone
don't
developers
them. Okay,
have
this
families.
Is becoming a shit show. So.
iPhone developers have a family to feed. And whenever you shit on an iPhone release, you're causing their family to starve and shit, and you're causing people to be fired, and they have like expensive homes and mortgages in Silicon Valley, and now they're fucked because of you shitting on an iPhone product.
I don't know.
So essentially, you gotta think the same way, but it's just like you're a team.
Okay,
you take it for the team.
You said your point. I get
and
your point. Everybody
that
gets
goes
your
the
point.
Same with the managers
okay,
parking in the
okay,
handicap
okay.
spaces.
Stop snapping.
Go fuck yourself.
Stop.
Okay, that's it. Go fuck yourself. So,
but nevertheless, I think result-wise, they will bring Icon and Winner. Don't worry, guys. I believe that. I think
people are very forgetful. They're gonna forget in 5 months.
Yeah,
it's okay. Job students, good job, college students. Good on you.
Yeah, what matters is the talks that are going around. Like, about YG and a society as a whole.
It keeps them in check. It keeps them in check.
But, like, at the same time, Winner and Icon didn't do anything bad. They have the right to perform.
There's no right to perform.
Yes, they
have
no
right to perform.
They have the right to perform.
Okay, there's no right. They can perform.
Yeah, they can perform in Hongdae if they want.
Yeah, there's no right.
If someone calls them, they have the right to perform.
Anybody has the right to perform.
They deserve the
There's no deserving. I hate
Shut up!
I hate this entitlement.
So this is the end of
There's
DK News. Thanks for watching this
Subscribe.
Week. Subscribe. Go check out our patreon.com/DKDKTV. We have reactions and podcasts. I bet Danny is going
to
ramble on this.
Now, okay, this is going to, we're going to talk about this
podcast.
Shit.
Check that out. And you can go follow me or Danny on Instagram. And follow DKDKTV on Instagram.
Yeah,
we're trying to promote our account. So go follow this. Sarah is working hard on our account.
Everybody say thank you, Sarah,
thank you,
for
Sarah,
editing this video, and we will see you guys next time.
Bye!